My name is Warren Woodberry, and today we're at the amateur boxing headquarters of the in Antigua, and this is the amateur boxing camp where we hope to develop top amateur boxers. And right now in Antigua, this is the first and only amateur camp that was ever located here. And we're on O'Parham Road outside of St. John's in the beautiful country of Antigua. What we found in Antigua, you know, with the good climate and everything, that they had a good history of having boxers. A lot of boxers came from here. Maurice Hope went on to become the English welterweight champion. And we found a lot of potential here for amateur boxing because of the weather conditions, and the fellows are in good shape. You got the beaches, you got 365 beaches, and the fellows get an opportunity to get in the water a lot. So when we found this condition, we found that they've had the potential to be good boxers. And when we found out there was good interest here, and there's always been a boxing country, we decided to see what could happen with an amateur boxing association and a program geared to define and find an amateur boxer. We started the program possibly in February, and we started on a ring, and we brought a few fellows forward. And a few of the young kids came, and they really wanted to get involved in it. And they showed great potential, a lot of physical fitness, and a lot of quick movement, and a lot of strength. As a result of that, they stuck with the program. And when Carifta started in Barbados in April, we took a young fella down there. And although he met much stiffer competition, his fight was declared the fight of the Carifta Games. And we found out that the boys here had the ability to fight, would fight. All we had to do is teach them the skill. So we set about setting up a training program and setting up a camp, and we called it Woodberry Park Boxing Club. We tried to enter some other people in starting clubs. The police department did come forward, and they set up a club. The defense forces in the process. And from this came the Amateur Boxing Association, which was formed in June. Another thing we found in amateur boxing here, most of the boxing here was professional boxing. So as a result, they viewed all professional boxing, and they didn't totally have a concept of what the amateur boxer was about. We're bringing that concept here to show them that it is a sport and a safety factor. And along with that, we feel that the young men here are going to be natural boxers because they have the movement, they have the strength, they have the quickness. And it's just a matter of time, more exposure, more involvement in the Pan American Games, Commonwealth Games. And when the Olympics come around this time, we're quite sure that many Caribbean countries will be represented. We hope in the future to have more visiting coaches from North America and from the other countries that have better developed programs. And this will assist our program because you have to take your training everywhere you can. And we know that the top training comes out of countries like Puerto Rico and United States and places like that, Canada and England. We are fortunate to have big matches scheduled. We have the England coming in, and they hope to give us a lot of exposure, a lot of experience. We have the United States team coming. We've made contact with the United States Army team, Marvin Johnson, and he's bringing the United States Army team in. So we haven't really slowed down in our approach. We're taking a very high marketing approach to promoting this amateur boxing and trying to get the fellows the benefit of all the best training that they can get. Along this direction, we also have contacted the Olympic Association and our organizations that are now just aware of the fact that Antigua has an amateur boxing program. And they have corresponded with us, and they plan to give us every assistance that they can. So it's going to be a concerted effort where everyone we feel that will come together in this program will just help promote the program that much better. And the young boxers will benefit, the country will benefit, because it's another feature of this beautiful country of Antigua. Sports is a very great part of this country. Basketball, the track, the athletics, netball, volleyball. Antigua is very involved in sports. And as a result of this love for sports, the amateur boxing program is just going to fit right in and just continue this love affair. We hope that the amateur boxing program will rise to the top, and we feel it will, because the fellows are so dynamic and so aggressive and so willing to participate in this program. We've been getting a lot of support from the business community, from the media, people that have come forward that have a lot of good ideas, and they actually feel that the amateur boxing program in Antigua is going to be one of the superior programs as soon as we put the proper network together. We are always open for ideas and anything that will assist the program from anyone in any area.
And just maybe being edged out on the inside, Raghu just walking into John Paul, who's still trying to box, both men going to the head. Nice to the left hand. Raghu all of a sudden begins to box again, scores a good short right hand. Sticks that left hand to the top, sticks the right to the top of the head. Ron Paul trying to box again. Scores a good combination punches. And trying to tie his man. On that occasion, he did put together a combination. He is warned for holding. So we are coming to the end of round number three. And quite a close contest. Paul again trying to jab. Gets caught to the right. Gets caught with a left hook to the top of the head. Gets caught with a left to the head. And the end of what has been a pretty fair contest. Quick work by the Trinidad. Here comes the local boy. Almost led, like how you see Tommy Hearns or Marvin Hagler led. Cortland Charles, 129. That's the introductions being done. Cortland Charles, 129 pounds, so just inside of the lightweight, just inside the lightweight. That's your third man in the ring, Warren Woodberry. And Warren would be just about to get the signal to go ahead. Most referees in international competitions will dress in white. Some will even wear a bow tie. So the Antiguan very busy, gets that left hand going, and snappy left hand, stands up and throws the right hand. Sure, this home crowd would like to see Antiguan victory, and a lot of power here being displayed. Manor a count, 2-3. Once the referee feels that the boxer is hurt, he stops the contest, gives him time to recover, counts 8, sees he's okay, standing 8 count, and tremendous power by Charles. I doubt whether this is going to go the distance, because Alonzo Clark will have to start boxing soon. He's standing and training, and really, Charles is just coming after his man. Break. When the referee says break, there should be no more punches. And there was a punch from Clark after the break. So by no means a classical battle. Clark trying to settle down once more. Being driven back. Trying to cover up. And again, being given an 8 count. 3 in any round will be detrimental to Clark. So he's had 2 in the opening round. And that's the Clark trying to match power with power. They work on the inside. Good left hand by Clark. Clark uppercutting. Uppercut by Charles. They pull the break, and again there is action after the break. When I tell you to break, you do. That should be the words of Warren Woodberry. And boxers deciding to work on the inside. Good, powerful double combination to the head. Clark trying to uppercut his man, doing quite well on the inside, but Charles covering up, and Clark guilty of leaning in his man. Good right hand, caught twice to the jaw, and maybe a case of a third and final 8 count. And fight awarded to the Antiguan, who really is in glee. So definitely Cortland Charles just too strong for Alonzo Clark. Clark 127 pounds and Cortland Charles 129 pounds. So victory to Antigua in this lightweight contest.
We feel that our program will definitely move the young men into the spotlight in the amateur boxing world. There's quite a few goals that we're trying to accomplish with the fellows that we have here. Our biggest goal, naturally, is the 1988 Olympics. As you know, amateur boxing is one of the biggest features of the Olympics, and we feel that Antigua has the potential. We have been assisted by some of the business community people, and Led has been declared one of our big brothers. Led has come forward and assisted the amateur boxers with their transportation to help them get more experience and international exposure. Another one of our big brothers is the House and Cove Beach Resort, which is one of the top five-star hotels, and that has also seen and had the vision to feel that amateur boxing in Antigua will be a very viable and up-and-coming sport.
Round one upcoming, and this is the last fight on this card. The 10th bout, a middleweight contest. And quickly there we see Rollins changing from orthodox to southpaw. Williams trying to cover up. He gets caught with a right hand, throws a good right hand himself, and they grab each other and slow the action down. Williams, that left hand caught quite high, gets caught with a right hand, scores with a right hand himself. Digs it right to the midsection. Easy to pick up the fighters. The condition in blue from Sugar City, and the Antiguan from Cricket Country in red. Almost slightly cocky, and gives an eight count. Doesn't really share the view of the referee, but the referee's the one calling the shots. You have to keep your hands up to indicate that you're in control. Referee Hall from Barbados, member of the Barbados Police Force. And this is round one in this middleweight contest. And Rollins just Williams covering up, but some of those punches went right through the defense of Williams. Rollins as he likes almost. Getting out of the way and clubbing his man. And the ring ropes just a little too loose. Begin to line up for action again. Williams really overawed by the power of Rollins. Rollins scores a good right hand. Williams still trying to fight back. And very good round for Rollins. Don't think that Williams knows where he is. Very much control.
Okay. Give it all the luck. Looks like that.
Some kind of control, but he's hurt. Ronald Williams definitely hurt. And I wouldn't be too surprised if this is not stopped. So we're about to have the start of round two, and I have my doubts whether this will go beyond this.
Brave start here by Williams. Rollins begins to fight back, slips his man. Wild punch to the back, warning given to Williams to throw the box on. Slip, push to the ground. Referee gets in between them very quickly to ensure no blows are thrown. And again, the boxers throw the box on. Rollins going for a haymaker. And quite right, very, very good judgment by Roy Gums, deciding that his man is just no match. No match at all. Victory to Calvin Rollins. Very, very good decision there by Roy Gums, deciding not to allow his man to be hurt, deciding that there's just no way he can come back, and obviously knowing that the young man can come and fight another day, making the right decision to stop the fight. Antigua much too strong for Simpkins.
Well,
the biggest amateur boxing card ever to be staged in Antigua has just been concluded, and no doubt from the Antiguan point of view, their preparation, like the rest of the OECS island, will be for Grenada in the middle of December. And who knows, the 1986 CAC Games in Santo Domingo, the Commonwealth Games in Scotland in 87, Pan American Games in 88, Korea. A lot of work still needs to be done, but amateur boxing definitely alive in Antigua and going in the right direction.